Hey everybody, I'm Dave Hecker, and I want to welcome you to the first installment of our series entitled, What is Agile Development? If you look up the term Agile Development, or what is Agile Development, on Google, you're going to get all these abstract and esoteric explanations with all kinds of, there's manifestos, and there's all these theories and all this high-level discussion. And it's hard for people to just get a clear answer to, you know, what is it? What does it really mean? So this series, we're going to try to just break it down and explain agile development in clear terms that everybody can understand. At a very high level, what is agile development? There's a few key things we could talk about. Number one is that it's a methodology. It's not a tool. It's not an exact way of writing requirements. It's not an exact way of communicating. It's a whole methodology. It is a type of project management. You could call it that. But really, it's a way of working as a team. I compare it sometimes to playing basketball. Sometimes you want to play man-to-man. Other times you want to play a zone. Those are two ways of executing the game of basketball. Agile is a way of executing software development project management. So it's a project methodology. Number two, agile is iterative. This means that we go in tight cycles. We'll work for a while, and then we'll see what we get. And then we'll revisit all the plans, make as many changes as we want, and start again. Those are usually called sprints or iterations. Those could be a week or 2 weeks. This is the total opposite of the waterfall technique, where we write a gigantic specification, and everybody works away on it, and then you get it signed by the client, and then you build to it like a blueprint. It's like building a high-rise building. Once the blueprint's done, you don't make any changes. That's the waterfall technique. Agile is the total opposite. We love changes. We revisit the plan constantly, and so we do tight iterations. Iterations is a huge concept in Agile. Third concept, Agile is very streamlined. When we do Agile development, we really favor getting to work and digging in and doing stuff, as opposed to having tons of documentation and a million meetings and all this process and overhead. So in Agile, we have a lot of quick meetings. We favor short, tight documentation over huge documents. We don't have a million milestones and a ton of process overhead. We're very, very streamlined. We want to move fast. Number four is the concept of time boxing. The term time boxing really just means that you're going to plan your work by time instead of by features. And this is a concept that takes time to get used to. In most projects, you'll say, we want to do feature A, B, and C. And we're going to do them in that order. And we're going to try to get them done in 3 weeks. We'll try to get them done in 3 weeks, but we'll see if we can possibly do that. We're definitely going to do those features. In Agile, we time box. We do it in the opposite way. We say we're going to do 3 weeks of development, and we're going to try to get features A, B, and C. We're rigid on time, not on features. If halfway through we get it all done, we'll say, great, let's add in feature D, which keep working because we planned 3 weeks of work. Agile is hugely collaborative. In an Agile project, everybody's talking to each other all the time. It's a fast-moving thing. You don't disappear for 2 weeks and come back with a finished product. So those are the key points about Agile. And when you put it at such a high level, it sounds great. It's so much better than the waterfall technique, right? But in reality, there's a lot of challenges, and Agile is tough. We're going to move on in this series, and we're going to come back next week with the next installment, where we're going to look at an Agile case study and walk our way through an actual Agile project, which is going to give you an idea of how it really works. And after that, we're going to drill down into specific topics like agile tools and the processes around those tools, how agile contracts work, agile pricing, and the big topic of agile culture, and a whole bunch more stuff. So in the meantime, be sure to subscribe to our channel, and we'll be giving out weekly tips and advice about outsourcing. As always, we want to hear from you. So please leave any questions or comments right down in the comments section. We'll answer any questions that come in. We'll see you soon. Thank you.